I'm Hema de Silva. I came from Sri Lanka, did my training in Albany and at the health center. And then I went into my fellowship in newborn care, and during which time I came to St. Francis. Part of the time we were on rotation. And at the time we had in the neonatal ICU was not in the form that it is today. It used to be like a, what we call a special care area. So babies who needed a little assistance were brought into that area. There was the bassinets and the usual, you know, little needs. And babies were taken care of by mostly the pediatricians. And things evolved, and in 77, as I was finishing my training, the opportunity opened up here at St. Francis. And I was, I guess, fortunate to get selected by Dr. Hart and Dr. Kramer, who was the chairman at Mount Sinai, for a joint appointment to the two institutions to basically supervise the pediatric residents and the nurse practitioners at Mount Sinai to provide care for the newborns that needed help. And as part of that, St. Francis sort of began to upgrade the services in the special care area. It was a much more family-oriented place. Everybody worked together. Staff was very loyal to the place and to the institutional needs. And I remember even when Mr. Dadles took over, he was walking through the units one day and he was saying something to me, and I said, "Don't tell me, tell them. It's the nurses who make the difference." I remember saying that to Dr. DeRemo. He was saying something about, he was thanking me for something. One of his friend's baby, grandbaby was with me and taking care of the baby, and he was thanking me, and I said, "Dave, I think you really have to say that to the nurses. They are the eyes and the ears. They spend 8 to 12 solid hours, now 12 hours and longer sometimes, with the baby. They see change, which they alert me about. If you waited for me, I mean, I'm there for 20, 30 minutes with one baby, I go to another baby, I go to another baby. They are the ones who is with that baby who can see some little change." And that was a lesson that we learned very early in my early training in Sri Lanka from my mentor there. Listen to your staff. They can tell you things before something bad really happens because of their experience, because of their interest and their commitment. And if you listen to them, you can avoid some of the pitfalls. I said, I think, you know, as I said, you know, I was very blessed, you know. I look back and say, thank God for the people that I had to work with. They cared about what they were doing, and so it made it easier. So it was a very, very good period of my life, you know.